Now I want to show you how to make a zebra from this little beauty right here.
Whoa! Stripes are my favorite pattern.
And spots, of course. But first, we make a work drawing.
I'll close up the box and glue down the flaps before we start. Now we can draw. Imagine a cardboard box, which turns into a zebra. It needs four long legs, big pointy ears, a shiny mane, a tail, eyes, nose, mouth, and of course, stripes.
First, we move the drawing onto the box one side at a time. Let's start by drawing the eyes. They are big, round, and look slightly to one side. Next, the nose. Also large and round. Draw three teeth sticking out and two large nostrils. Take a marker pen and draw over the pencil marks. Strong and clear lines show up really well when you are painting. If you don't have a marker pen, use a thin brush dipped in paint. Yeah, I know, it looks more like a pig now. Just wait.
Add!
Let's prepare all the parts before we stick them on. We'll start by drawing everything we need on a piece of cardboard. The mane is sharp and jagged. Big ears. Tongue. And a tail. Grab your marker pen and draw over the tail and the tongue. Cut everything out, and they are ready for glue. You'll need to fold some flaps for gluing. Use a ruler to get them nice and straight. It's good to put some glue into a bowl. You can dip stuff in or use a brush. Let's dab a bit of glue on the flaps and glue the ears on. Now, tape up the middle of the box, ready for the next part, the mane. Check to see how much glue you need. Then squeeze on a line of glue. Yep, it fits perfectly. Use some sticky tape to support the mane while the glue dries. It can be a bit loose at first, but once the glue dries, it'll be just fine. Next, stick the tongue on the same way. Now stick on the tail. Finally, the legs. These are toilet rolls dipped in glue and stuck on. It's important to get loads of glue on the ends so that the legs stick firmly to the body. Ah, perfect.
Øistein, when are the stripes coming?
Well, in fact, almost right now.
Paint!
Then we paint it up. Let's start with the white base. Now, let's paint the zebra. Everything except the mane. I'm using a white base because the zebra is in fact completely white under the stripes. I'm using water-based acrylic paint, which you can buy at most hobby or art shops. Paint the large surfaces with a broad brush. Paint the face and other details with a small brush. Don't worry if you paint over any of the marker pen lines. We'll fix those later. Here's one that I painted earlier. Now, get some black paint. We'll do the mane first. Use plenty of paint. This helps to strengthen the cardboard so your zebra lasts longer. While you're at it, paint the nose black. Now, switch to red paint for the tongue. Switch again to pink. And paint the inside of the ears. And have about a little blue ring around one eye. Here's one already painted and dry. Check it out! Pretty great, right? Even without stripes. Time to freshen up those marker pen lines that might have disappeared under the paint. You can also use a thin brush dipped in black paint. We are ready for the main event, the stripes. Start on one side and paint some stripes down the side. On the back, on top, the other side, the ears, and the face. Use any pattern you like, just have fun. Finally, put some bright yellow in one eye to bring out some color on this otherwise black and white animal. Look at this! One cute and sweet zebra! Wow! Let's see it one more time. First, draw the zebra on the box with pencil and marker pen. Next, draw and make all the extra zebra parts and glue them on. Ears, mane, tongue, tail and legs. Then, paint the white base color, add some other colors, and finally, paint some stripes. You can also turn your zebra into a trendy gift box. Get an adult to help you with this. Cut along the red lines, open up the lid and pop in a gift. Okay, Box, do you have any more ideas for us?
Yeah, I just wanted to say that you can use the same techniques to make other cool gift boxes, such as this giraffe box.
Now it's ready for a special friend. There are thousands of ways you can box yourself. Just use your imagination.